everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Pokemon Emerald Part Bonus Episode 3. Yeah, I don't know what I'm talking about all of a sudden. Okay, so let's go ahead and heal our Pokemon real quick, since I forgot to do so, apparently. I believe in this part, we're going to be taking a little bit of a break from catching the legendaries. We will be doing more of that in the future, obviously, since we have several more to catch, at least four that I can think of off the top of my head that we're going to be catching. However, in the meantime, we are going to be going to somewhere else, somewhere far, far away. Not really, but far enough away to call it far away. And we have already gotten information about what we're going to be doing, but now we're actually going to be doing it. Yes. See, I don't know which would be the better place to start at. Let's go to Slateport. I don't really remember exactly how this works. It's been a while since I've done this. So we're just going to mess around until we can do stuff. So if you remember, we got an invitation from Scott. So now we're going to take him up on that offer. Hello, are you here for the ferry? May I see your ticket? We flashed her the tickets. Perfect, that's all you need. And where would you like to go? Lilico City. Lilico City is, then please board the ferry and wait for departure. So I think we have to go to one of the other places through the ferry first before we can actually go to where we're planning to go. Well, hi, hi, Joel. Something's come up, so I have to disembark. Am I glad to see you. Congratulations, League Champion. There's a place I'd like to invite someone like you. It's the Battle Frontier. What's the place like? You'll understand when you see it. I've spoken with the ship's captain about this. Next time you take a ferry, you should be able to sail to the Battle Frontier. Okay, Joel, I'll be waiting for you at the Battle Frontier. Can I off the ride and come back? No. This ferry is built to plow through fast-running currents. We hope you enjoyed your voyage with us. Feel free to explore the ship, lad. Okay, so I don't remember what all we do in here. I know we can battle people, but I don't know if we have to battle people and if we do. Oh, hey!
Welcome aboard, Joel! They made me honorary captain of the SS title. You can call me Captain Riley now. You know, I retired once before, but when I saw this majestic ship, let me just say it stirred my sleeping soul as a sailor.
That's not lovely!
We get to meet an old face. Literally, he's old. And he has a face. So I think this place is mostly battling. I don't remember exactly off the top of my head. But we found leftovers, which is awesome. Seriously, this thing is awesome. Where is it? Leftovers. Hold on, then gradually restores HP and metal. This is like one of the best items ever, let me just say. And we're going to be giving it to Grumpig because of its substitute and toxic combo. Means I can be a lot better at stalling now. Be very, very good. But basically, at the end of every turn, leftovers restores 1/8, I believe, of your health. It's a pretty substantial amount, too. It's none to laugh at, kid. See if we can get by without having to fight either of these sailors. Oh. Okay. Secret agent boy, secret agent boy, doesn't know where he is going or what to do.
It'll be some time before we land, I reckon. You can rest up in your cabin if you'd like. Yours, your cabin is number 2. The bed there is soft and plushy, I made sure myself. I can attest to how comfy it is. Really, you didn't even have to have me go there, you went there yourself, game. Okay. So here's our little cabin, and we can sleep. Let us take a rest. Okay.
We've made land in Lily Cove. Thank you for sailing with us on the SS title. I've been your host, Mr. Crewman. We've arrived. Congratulations. This place looks the exact same as Slateport, but nonetheless.
Hello, are you here for the ferry? May I see your ticket?
And we flash her with it again.
Perfect, that's all you need. And where would you like to go?
We're going to go to the Battle Frontier!
Battle Frontier it is, then. Please board the ferry and wait for departure.
Okay.
Okay, so this time I don't think we actually have to battle or anything. Yeah, so here we are at the Battle Frontier. I don't know. The Battle Frontier. I've dreamed about a place like it. This place is actually pretty cool. So here we have the first gate.
Is it your first time here? Please step this way. The front lines of Pokemon battling. Welcome to the Battle Frontier. For a first time visitor, we issue the Frontier Pass. It's for use at all the facilities in the Battle Frontier. Here you are.
We got the pass!
So we actually get that put in our trainer card, I'm not sure why.
We hope you enjoy all the Battle Frontier has to offer.
Well, if it isn't Joel, it came out here.
Oh, Mr. Scott, sir. Good day to see you, sir.
It's great to see you here. It really is. I hope you'll take your time and explore everywhere. Naturally, I hope you'll experience the pure essence of battling. I also have my quarters here, so feel free to visit if you have time.
Oh. Okay.
So, Mr. Scott is actually an important person here.
He's actually, I believe, the owner of the Battle Frontier.
So that's pretty cool. So here, we have basically a bunch of different places. They're all interesting in and of themselves. This is Battle Factory. Seek out the toughest Pokemon. Battle Factory, I'm probably not going to show a whole lot of these, just because it'll take a long time.
But Battle Factory, we kind of experienced it earlier with Battle Tint. It basically, when you're there, you get to select a group of randomized Pokemon. And then you battle with those. At the end of each fight, you can select one to switch out for an opponent, and all that. So there's a Pokemon Center, some houses. I don't remember if there's anything really unique here.
I may not look that impressive now, but I once beat a gym leader. Who knows? Maybe I should give it another shot of glory.
Who knows? So there are various places like that. And then there's the just pure battle tower, which is battling in a tower. It's pretty straightforward. It's a battle arena. I don't remember what the ballerina, as I think I accidentally said there, actually is. But, down here, if I can get down here, this is what? The Battle Palace. Again, I don't really remember half of these. The main ones I remember, the Battle Pike, the Battle Tower, and the Battle Factory, those are the main ones I actually spent time at. The Battle Pike is an interesting one. I mean, they're all interesting. They all have their own unique rules that are pretty interesting. This is actually a very fun place, and I very much enjoy that they took the time to put the effort into this. What's this? It wiggles. Kind of weird. Let's talk to this old lady.
Excuse me, young one. Have you good eyesight? There's an old tree past here, and my tired eyes, it seems to wiggle.
May have Charles Bonnet syndrome, but it does appear to wiggle.
Well, that's interesting. So what was I saying? Yes, all of them are interesting. I didn't want to hop off right there, but that's okay. Not really, but okay. Let's go ahead and put up a referral real quick. See, I'll probably be looking at one or two of these places, but not a whole lot of them. It'll just take way too much time to really show all of them. I might spend a little time at the Battle Tower, maybe. So, a lot of you are probably now asking, what's the point of doing stuff in here? First off, it's fun. Second off, if we go to our new trainer card, we can get battle points. What these battle points do... Oh yeah, we also have a little map up here. So here's the Battle Tower, then we have the Battle Dome over here. Battle Palace, Battle Arena, Battle Factory, Battle Pike, and the Battle Pyramid. So what we do with these battle points, well, whenever you win an event, you get a certain number of battle points, and the tougher rank place you beat and such, the more battle points you get and such, fairly straightforward, but what you do with them is pretty fun. And has a lot of good stuff, actually. Battle Point Exchange Service Counter. Exchange your battle points. So here we have lots of people. So here at this particular place, we can get various dolls, which are pretty cool because they're pretty cool dolls. We got Blastoise, Venusaur, Charizard, Snorlax, Lapras. They all cost a lot of points, but, you know, it's the price we pay. Get it? Because we're paying prize. And points. We accrue. Here we can get various posters. Lots of Kiss stuff. That's kind of weird. I thought Kiss made music, not posters. Well, they probably make posters too. But anyway, that's beside the point. Probably very different kinds of posters, though. Here we can get all of the vitamins, which is actually pretty convenient because they only cost one battle point apiece, so they're not that bad. Here we can get various items like leftovers, which is really good, white herb, quick claw, mental herb, which prevent or snaps out of infatuation, bright powder, choice band, king's rock, focus band, and scope lens. Some very good stuff. That's probably the biggest place, is that particular person is, because you can get a lot of really good items, which you're going to want and need, especially if you want to actually do well in the Battle Tower. The Battle Tower, it's pretty hard, actually, especially if you just have randomly trained Pokemon. You're probably going to have a very hard time. You really want to get EV trained Pokemon. What do you say? I believe I'm the only person here who, for some reason, would choose fishing over battling. Huh? You can't catch anything here? Well, that's disappointing. Yeah, I don't think you can actually catch anything in these particular waters, but I might be mistaken. There's so much here. This is why I love Emerald, because they added, honestly, a lot in this game. There's a lot of extra stuff. I'm trying to figure out, because I know we can get down to that cave. I'm trying to remember how. I don't remember how, because we need to get below that. We need to get past Wiggling Tree. I don't remember how that is done, actually. I need an adult. Who can give me what I need? I know what I need, too. That's the worst part. Do you know what I need? Can you give me what I need? I don't care if you're busy. Give me what I need, good sir. And or madam. Okay, well, we should try somewhere else. Okay, do you have what I need? Oh, darling, you're so wonderful. Oh, I just can't wait anymore. Oh, well. Let's go to a multi-battle room this instant. If we get together in the battle salon, the love of our power, will overcome everyone we meet. Why, before us, darling, everything will topple like dominoes. Okay, then. Who gives me what I need? You do not give me what- No, I do not want to talk to you again, lady. Miss Lady. I know someone here should give me what I need. But I do not know who it is. This is a mystery to me. Okay, then. So, if I haven't already, which I probably have, I'm going to cut to when I find the person who I need to talk to. So over here, in the... Well, show you where it is after we get out. But up here we have a trainer who will trade their Meowth for a Skitty. So if you want a Persian, that's a good place to get a Meowth. So, yeah, we're just left at the Battle Tower. So, back to searching. So just left of where we were. If we just keep going a little bit to the left, as you can see, not very far, there's this house. And in this house is a Scott. Well, hello and welcome. Sorry about the cramped space. Anyway, Joel, let me formally welcome you to the Battle Frontier. This is my dream come true. It took me years and years, but I finally given shape to my dream. On reflection, it was a terribly long journey. I left home on a quest to find strong trainers. Then we can imagine how much effort or time it took to make this real. But that's all in the past. No point in dwelling on that. All I want for you is to enjoy to your heart's content here, battling stuff. Julie wanted you to have this as a memento for all the time our paths crossed on journeys. So we got 2 battle points. Yay! We can buy 2 vitamins. Yay! You have already... Well, you haven't told us this, but we have already known this. I also just remembered during talking what I need to use, and I feel like a dumb person. Probably because I am. Anyway, let us go back swiftly to the tree. Now that I've completely and totally shown how incredibly thick I can be. Where are you, Mr. Tree? I want to meet you. Okay, so now we do the obvious thing. You are the tree. The weird tree doesn't seem to like the Whalmer Pail. The weird tree attacked. What? Wait, what? So this is the Pokemon Sudowoodo. This was introduced in the second generation, and in a similar event to this, looks the exact same. It's pretty cool. It's not really that great of a Pokemon, but you know, it's a Pokemon. So let's hit it with a Pursuit. Hopefully that won't kill it. It shouldn't. It's level 40. Scepter can't escape. Oh no. Okay, so let's go ahead and see if we can catch this thing. Just because. It's not a legendary. It is a unique Pokemon. You're not going to be able to find another Sudowoodo. But it's just a unique Pokemon. Not actually a legendary, though. Certainly not legendary in stats. But that's a whole nother thing. It is... It can be good if you want to try to make it good, but it's not. There are a lot better rock types. There are much more rock types that rock. On that note, I'm going to cut until we catch it. And or fail. And there we go. We have caught Sudowoodo. The imitation Pokemon. It mimics a tree to avoid being attacked by enemies, but since its 4 legs remain green throughout the year, it is easily identified as a fake in the winter. How unfortunate. So now, we can actually go to the cave. Okay. I believe it's over here. To the left, if I am correct. I'm not actually sure that I am anymore. Yep, I am. Hey, what do you know? So here we are in the Artisan Cave. In the Artisan Cave are various things, primarily this. That being Smeargle. Smeargle's a very interesting Pokemon. Very, very interesting. It has one move, Sketch. It has 1 PP, and it is replaced permanently with whatever move it copies with its Sketch ability. So, it's an interesting Pokemon. Not necessarily astounding. More astounding in... Okay, well that was a great example of it. More astounding in competitive battling, but it is a very interesting Pokemon. What's good about it is you can make it have whatever moveset you want. Because of the fact that it copies whatever move was last used by the targeted Pokemon. So here we have an HP up. Basically, in the Artisan Cave, there isn't really anything interesting. All that's in the Artisan Cave is just Smeargle and a couple of vitamins, so I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time there. If you didn't have a Pokemon with Fly, you'd be stuck down here. That's rude. Anyway, I think I would rather spend a little bit of time fighting against some of the peoples in some place. Let's see, where would you like to go? I don't really know. Most of the places are interesting, but I don't want to show off many of them because I'm not going to show more than one place. Because otherwise it's just going to take too long, and none of them are really... I do not know what to do. Pulse effect wore off. I think for the meantime, maybe we'll do something later, but I think for the meantime we are going to call it for this episode, and maybe in the future we'll do one of these places. But for now, I think that showing what this place is, describing to you what some of these places are, I think that'll be good for now. Perhaps? I don't know. But anyway, next time we'll probably be back catching a legendary, so until then, thank you for watching and farewell.